अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन, टुडे आवर टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज हाइपर एल्डोस्टेरोनिज्म। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग हाइपर एल्डोस्टेरोनिज्म, आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस द लिटिल बिट फिजियोलॉजी ऑफ रेनिन एंजियोटेंसिन एल्डोस्टेरोन एक्सिस। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। व्हेन देयर इज अ डिक्रीज्ड रीनल परफ्यूजन एंड डिक्रीज्ड सोडियम लेवल्स और देयर इज अ सिंपथेटिक स्टिमुलेशन, ऑल दीज आर द वेरियस स्टिमुलाई विच कॉजेज द रिलीज ऑफ रेनिन फ्रॉम द जेजी सेल्स ऑफ प्रॉक्सिमल कन्वोल्यूटेड टिब्यूल। From the liver, angiotensinogen protein is released. This renin acts on the angiotensinogen and convert it into angiotensin 1. When this angiotensin 1 passes through the pulmonary circulation, enzyme is released from the pulmonary circulation which is called angiotensin converting enzyme or ACE, and convert angiotensin 1 into angiotensin 2. And this angiotensin 2 acts on the adrenal gland zona glomerulosa. And from the zona glomerulosa, aldosterone mineralocorticoid hormone is released. This aldosterone has three important functions. This aldosterone acts on the principal cells of the collecting tubules and causes sodium reabsorption, loss of potassium into the urine, as well as loss of H positive ion into the urine. So it causes hypernatremia, hypokalemia, and metabolic alkalosis because of loss of H positive ions into the urine. Now come to the hyperaldosteronism. There are two types of hyperaldosteronism, mean increased level of aldosterone levels. One is primary and the other one is secondary. When the cause of the hyperaldosteronism is adrenal gland itself, this is called primary hyperaldosteronism. It means that the excessive production of aldosterone from adrenal gland, this is called primary hyperaldosteronism. Now come to the causes of primary hyperaldosteronism. The most common cause is bilateral adrenal hyperplasia. This is the most common cause of hyperplasia. The second cause is adrenal adenoma. And the third cause is glucocorticoid suppression, hyperaldosteronism. Glucocorticoid suppression, hyperaldosteronism. These are the three causes of primary hyperaldosteronism. Now come to secondary hyperaldosteronism. In this case, the cause is not the adrenal gland, but the stimulation or the excessive renin. When there is increased level of renin, it causes the stimulation of renin angiotensin aldosterone axis and increases the levels of aldosterone. So here the pathology is not within the adrenal gland. Now come to the causes of secondary hyperaldosteronism. The most important cause is inadequate renal perfusion. There are many causes of inadequate renal perfusion. The most important cause is renal artery stenosis, congestive cardiac failure, liver failure, nephrotic syndrome and diuretics. These are the various causes which causes the stimulation of renin angiotensin aldosterone axis and increases the levels of aldosterone. Now come to the clinical features of hyperaldosteronism. There are three main functions of hyperaldosteronism: increased sodium, decreases potassium, and metabolic alkalosis. Due to increased sodium, it causes the water retention, which leads to hypertension. Now, due to the hypertension, the sign and symptoms of hypertension develops like headache and blur vision, etc. Remember, the most important thing is there is no edema in case of hyperaldosteronism. Why? Because of aldosterone escape mechanism. When there is a hypertension or pressure overload or volume overload because of excessive sodium in the body, it causes the release of atrial natriuretic peptide. This increased atrial natriuretic peptide causes natriuresis, means the loss of sodium in urine, natriuresis as well as diuresis. So it prevents the formation of edema in case of hyperaldosteronism. And now come to decreased potassium levels. Due to hypokalemia, polyuria may develop. Polyuria and polydipsia may develop. Because of decreased potassium, renal tubular reversible damage may occur. Renal tubular reversible damage. Reversible damage may occur and causes polyuria and polyuria. And due to this decreased potassium, muscle weakness and flaccid paralysis may occur. The third important is metabolic alkalosis, and this metabolic alkalosis rarely causes a symptom, which is tetany. Because of metabolic alkalosis, there is increased pH in the blood. This increased pH gives excessive negative charge to albumin, and with this albumin, calcium got bind, and when this ionized calcium binds with the albumin, there is decreased ionized calcium, and this decreased ionized calcium in the blood causes tetany. But this is not very common feature, this is uncommon. The common features are hypertension and polyuria. Remember, the most important thing is there is no edema in case of hyperaldosteronism. Now, another important point is in whom we should suspect that these are the patients of hyperaldosteronism. When the patient came in the OPD with hypertension and in the electrolyte report there is hypokalemia. Hypertension with hypokalemia is the important feature we can suspect that these patient has hyperaldosteronism. And if the patient of hypertension comes in the OPD with very young age, and the third important feature is in which we can suspect that these are the patients of hyperaldosteronism is, one is hypertension with hypokalemia, hypertension with very young age, and hypertension resistant to conventional therapies, means the normal drugs cannot control the blood pressure, resistant, conventional therapy resistant. Now come to the diagnosis or investigations of hyperaldosteronism. Before the investigation, a doctor should stop the beta blockers and diuretics, because these beta blockers have negative effect on the renin-angiotensin aldosterone axis, and these diuretics can stimulate renin-angiotensin aldosterone axis. Instead, we can use alpha blockers and calcium channel blockers, like prazosin is alpha blocker and calcium channel blockers are amlodipine and efidipine. We can use these medications 4 weeks before the investigation to control the blood pressure of the patient, Now come to the screening test. The most important screening test is serum aldosterone to renin ratio. In case of primary hyperaldosteronism, aldosterone levels are high, but renin levels are low. So aldosterone to renin ratio is high. If it is more than 30, then we can suggest that the patient has primary hyperaldosteronism. In order to confirm, the confirmatory tests are, number one is saline infusion test. In this saline infusion test, this is a confirmatory test. In this, we give the patient IV saline. In healthy normal individuals, excessive sodium in the body suppresses the renin-angiotensin aldosterone axis. But in case of primary hyperaldosteronism, instead of giving saline infusion, there is increased aldosterone. So it is a confirmatory test. And the second important test is sodium oral loading test. Give the patient excessive sodium for 3 days and then check urine, electrolytes and aldosterone. If there is more sodium in the urine along with more aldosterone, it is confirmatory test of primary hyperaldosteronism. Aldosterone measurement. if the adrenal venous sampling, in both the adrenal venous sampling, aldosterone is high, it means the cause is bilateral hyperplasia of adrenal gland. If bilaterally increased levels of aldosterone in venous sampling, if unilateral increase, it means the cause is adrenal adenoma. We can perform the imaging techniques like CT scan of the adrenal gland to confirm anatomically whether it is bilateral hyperplasia or it is adrenal adenoma. Now come to that, how can we diagnose the secondary hyperaldosteronism? We perform the renin and aldosterone levels. In secondary hyperaldosteronism, as we have discussed in previously, that in this case renin levels as well as aldosterone levels are raised. This increased renin stimulates the renin angiotensin aldosterone axis, and as a result aldosterone's levels are very high in case of secondary hyperaldosteronism. Now last but not least, come to the management of primary hyperaldosteronism. In case of adenoma of the adrenal gland, adrenalectomy is the treatment of choice, means that the removal of adrenal gland. But in case of bilateral hyperplasia of adrenal gland, surgery is contraindicated. In this case, we will give the patient spironolactone, eplerenone. These are the drugs which are actually the blockers of aldosterone, antagonists of aldosterone, and decreases the aldosterone level. In this way, we can treat hyperaldosteronism. Thank you so much for watching this video.